Welcome to this very important dialogue with Krishi Rishi Subhash Parekar on sustainable agriculture. I have a question here because I remember, I think our civilization is identified with agriculture civilization. It's identified with the knowledge civilization, yeah. Both the things. We had Sujalam Sufalam, this whole thing for centuries together. We have many historical examples and how the system was developed for several. I also remember in my childhood, we used to have bountiful of farm when after independence. But during the 60s, what I saw was that there were droughts, successive droughts, which took place. And people were really going hungry. And I remember when we used to come from my engineering college in Nagpur and go back to the village, people had nothing to eat. Many places, and even in Mumbai, when I traveled, there was no food in India at that time because of successive droughts. It is in this context that really the Green Revolution, the seeds of Green Revolution came, Norman Borlaug and other things, you know, this one, Professor M.S. Swaminathan, C. Subramaniam, of course, at that time, the agriculture minister, and a Green Revolution. We saw that whole thing is that the hybrid seeds, sort of first time we saw hybrid seeds. Yeah. First time we saw the grid, the fertilizers, then we saw chemicals and pesticides and the markets being developed on this one. And I think, of course, the thing which came out that that we became self-sufficient in the food and people were, we are able to feed at that time the population of, say later on, the population of 40 crores, 50 crores and all that thing. And Green Revolution was hailed as a great contribution to this thing. And Norman Borlaug was given the Nobel Prize and all that thing we have seen this whole journey. Now we are talking about, but you seem to be believing that Green Revolution is not really a revolution. In that sense, it has not been a sustainable revolution at all. So why do you say so?
Basically, we have to find define what is actual sustainable agriculture. And my definition is that agricultural technology is sustainable agriculture by which all the natural resources will be sustained. And that is the real definition, I think that. Mm-hmm. But what has happened, Augustus Liebig has devised the philosophy of Green Revolution, and Norman Borlaug had developed the technology of Green Revolution. And at that time, they were realizing that what are the natural resources are unlimited. We can utilize in maximum quantity. There is no limit. And for that purpose, through this viewpoint, they have devised this technology and they have started chemical farming throughout the world. What has happened? By means of the Green Revolution, when the up till the productivity of the soil was sustainable, mm-hmm. the farmers has got best result. But when the productivity of the soil was starting to decline, then production was started to decline. This is totally straight connected to productivity of the soil, sir. And not only productivity, all the natural resources, that means soil, water, environment, and even human resources also, all they are totally exploited by means of the Green Revolution. And as a result, we are seeing that there are so many problems they have created. Food crisis is the big problem. Global warming, climate change is another problem. Migration of the youth from rural area to urban area is a big problem. And even the suicide of the farmers and also suicide of the consumers also, because they are dying by cancer, diabetes, heart attack, these are the committed suicides. So these problems are created. I think that what the realization of that Green Revolution promoter, that natural resources are unlimited, we can utilize as many as possible, mm-hmm. is totally wrong. So now we have to give that technology by which the natural resources will be sustained, the natural resources will not be destroyed, and we will keep, we will conserve, we will protect all the natural resources for future generations. And my technology and my philosophy is, I think that we have shown that by means of the zero-based natural farming, we can sustain all natural resources, and we have proved by means of our models.
So can we make a statement now, that is a very important statement which we are trying to bring out, and which I am also very interested in, is that current green revolution, what we call, we have termed as a green revolution, the first green revolution we have talked about, is not sustainable based on chemical fertilizers, insecticide, pesticides, hybrid farming, or the mechanized farming is not sustainable. Is that, will you agree with that? Will you make that statement today?
Because that soil of Punjab, the Punjabi farmers were getting 30 quintal per acre wheat production by means of green revolution before 25 years. Now, they are not getting more than 15 quintal or 12 quintal per acre. Mm. Because the productivity is totally declining. Mm. And if it will be continue in next future, then how we can grow to 50 crore metric ton of food grain for to fulfill our 160 crore Indians in future up to 2050. It is not totally possible, impossible. It is totally impossible. But we have seen and we have shown by means of the zero budget natural farming, we have shown that we can increase the production per acre of every crop. I will give two examples. Basmati rice is a local variety. It is well known in the world. You utilize maximum quantity of the chemical fertilizer, you will not get more than 12 quintal per acre production in chemical farming. Mm. But now, by means of zero budget natural farming, our farmers are taking up to 24 quintal per acre. By means of, we have shown that in zero budget natural farming, local seeds also has a capacity to give more production than hybrid seeds and genetically modified seeds. We have shown, even in the wheat, these are two main food staple crops, rice and wheat. In wheat also, Deshi Bansi variety will not give more than 6 quintal per acre in chemical farming. But we have shown our farmers are getting 18 quintal per acre also.